Good to see you all. Thank you for having us. And I'm sorry these chairs are so off kilter.
I'm trying to make him feel okay because his chair is sunk a little bit.
No, it's pretty accurate.
Do I have a phone book anywhere?
This is how it is.
Wow.
This is our power level.
Yeah. This is how he likes to think it works.
Yes. Make sure there's always 3 feet between things.
Are we allowed to breathe?
Don't touch him. And don't talk about it.
Yes. And dress them for the party.
You did. Argyle's coming back. Very nice.
It's in. It's already in.
Yeah, I brought it in. It's really old school.
Yeah. And John, great t-shirt. Nice. Looks great.
It's got a pocket and everything.
Pockets on t-shirts are coming back.
Thank you.
Yeah. Jeez,
do you believe it's been 15 years since this movie?
I just Googled that. And, it's magical. It's wonderful. It has been 15 years, but it feels like, I mean, I hear something about it every day of my life. And that
do you really?
A wonderful, wonderful thing, camera two. I just love it.
There's a list of movies that when you're channel surfing around and you find it, no matter what you're doing, you stop and watch the movie. Your movie is one of those. What's that quality that why you hear about it every day, why I stop and watch it every time that I see it on?
Well, it's turned me into a bit of a hermit because if I go outside, then I hear something. So I just stay indoors all day. And and it's starting to affect my skin color. And, it's a. What do you guys think?
Now, he's fixing his microphone. He's
got me double wired just in case. Yeah. I got one going to the NSA before. And one right here. Anyway, the film for us, I think I can speak for all of us. You know, it represents something that's a little more than just a memory and a classic film. I think that we know this film's brought a lot of families together. We talk to people all the time who say, yeah, this is the only film that the grandparents can sit with the grandkids and the parents in between and everybody, and the dog, too.
Oh, look at this. Your football skills are fantastic.
They're showing it again.
And just so you know, I threw that steak. I actually threw that from off camera because I got a wing ding of an arm. And I nailed him. And you see Efren running out. Pedro runs out because he was kind of supposed to stand there a little longer, but he was laughing. So he had to get out of the frame because it was a hit or miss.
We had no stunt guys, so it's like that really happened. I thought, okay, this is totally independent.
And the, and the slap from the stake hitting him, this you can say.
Was this real. Was like shot in
There's no sound effects.
No. This was
shot
CGI.
In 23 days on like virtually no money
22
at all.
On film.
On film.
Yeah.
On actual film.
So we were budgeted in every way possible. Yeah.
And Efren, your character is just so understated and brilliant. Did you have any idea that Pedro would become this iconic character?
I thought you said this psychotic character.
The psychotic character.
Well, this is a film about the underdog, you know, and friendships and relationships. And I thought what they were talking about, why it became so huge, is because these guys come from nowhere and they become friends, and I'm talking about Napoleon and Pedro, and in that friendship they help each other's dreams come true, which is pretty cool. So, and in the end, every single character something happens, something positive, and I think that goes back to why this film is resounding even after 15 years, because they're relatable and there's a really strong positive message with every single person.
You still see people walking around with a Vote for Pedro t-shirts.
Of course.
Every time.
I expect that for 2020.
Yeah. I read that when they were shooting the dance sequence at the end that they actually ran out of film. I think we have video of that. And then they just kind of spliced together your best moments?
It was definitely one of the last things we shot. I don't remember running out of film, although I think they just basically said for each shot, we're only going to do three takes. So after that, and I told them, two takes, I'm good. But no, we need some more good stuff. I was like, fine, I'll try Heath through the next 3 minutes.
Was this a detailed choreographed dance move?
Absolutely.
Are you freestyling?
This is all freestyle, baby. Yeah. This is essentially what I do in front of the mirror after a fresh shower every morning, only with less clothes. Jared Hess, who wrote and directed the film, he knew I liked to boogie. So he put that into the script, and I was like, all right, let me just do my thing. I don't know how to choreograph anything, so.
I read that you two have identical twins.
That's correct.
Is that true? And
yes.
That must be weird for them to see you guys. Are they jealous of your success? Maybe I'll ask it that way.
We're jealous of their success because we are the twins. This is live, and this is finally. It feels so good to get out of here.
Get out of here.
Oh, my gosh, finally. I can run free.
But there's something about the anonymity. They probably don't have anonymity because they look like you.
They hang out together. Yeah. They go out together, the twins, the other brothers.
Yeah, yeah.
So does
you ruin one life, you ruin two lives. In this case, it's four lives.
They actually dress like the characters every day.
Yeah. They're like, no, it wasn't me. It's my brother. Yeah. I gotcha.
Weirdly, is my brother has like way more hair and pounds on him than I do, and yet people will go to him first. So I'm like, what's happening? This is stupid.
Yeah, they just figure that, you know, you've let yourself go.
Yeah, they're right. Like, this is natural. Like, obviously, it's a natural evolution. As amazing as it did years later. I'm like, you guys still here?
Which Napoleon lines do people quote back to you most often? Since you hear about it every day, I'm assuming they're doing the voice and the lines to you, right?
Well, yeah, they try to do the voice. no, I think the one that took me by surprise from day one was everybody loves the Tina, you fat lard. Come get some ham. And it's like, I never thought that was going to be a quotable line because it's like such a specific line. Like, well, you gotta have ham, you gotta have a Tina, and she's gotta be fat. Right? Yeah. Like, no, we just send that to whoever. I'm like, that's sweet. I think, what else? What other lines?
Well, I had a friend of mine who stored my number on her phone as Pedro, and she had lost her phone, and then it got online everywhere, and people were calling my number up, saying, hello, is Pedro there? And I'm like, oh my God. They're like, are you really Pedro? I'm like, who is this? So it'd be surprising.
And people are just asking you to throw steaks all the time.
No, they're just basically, my line is either, back in 82, I used to be able to throw a pigskin a quarter mile, or I think the other one is, how does the dealio sound to
you? You know, it's a good problem to have, I would think, that people are so drawn to this movie and still love it after this amount of time,
well,
right?
I know we love this movie.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, I mean, not that we sit around and watch it, but if it does come on and somebody happens to be over at the house and they're like, no, let's just watch it, you know, they like to know that you're sitting right there watching the movie. You know?
So what's going to happen tonight at the Genesee? Are you going to show the movie first and then you guys do the Q&A after?
Yeah. And the Q&A is kind of almost a little bit of a show itself. I mean, it's freestyle.
Yeah.
It's all freestyle. Yeah. It's also, don't think that there's going to be dancing.
Yeah.
Because they might.
It might just be. It may not be. It depends if they have the music queued up.
Depends on how close I am to your lap. You know?
The fact that there are kids who are like 7 years old or 15 years old and they're dressed up as the characters in Napoleon Dynamite.
Wow. Oh, so they'll show up like that.
Oh, yeah. They'll bring cakes, bring, you know, pinatas.
There's a whole new generation.
Tater tots.
They'll bring tater tots. Yeah. They'll bring chapsticks. And chapsticks I can use. Tater tots.
They'll throw footballs. They bring footballs.
Thanks, guys. God. Great to have you in this morning.
Thanks for being here.
Again, they're at the Genesee Theater in Waukegan. Go to GenesseeTheater.com. Great to meet y'all.
This is pretty much the worst video ever made.